Hey guys, it's Utonia here, and today I'm going to talk about the Harpy, which is the Tech 2 variation of the Merlin. The Harpy is an assault frigate, and I think it's in a very good place right now. It's probably the healthiest assault frigate. It is both really strong in solo and in fleets too. So the fit I use is pretty much like you take the all-in Merlin and you just make it even better with more money. So I've got four Tech 2 line Neutron Blasters up here in the highs. There's an empty high slot here. You can fit like an offline probe launcher if you want, core probe launcher, that could be quite useful. I've got a Restrained Microwarpdrive, a Caldari Navy Medium Shield Extender for CPU. You can go with the compact Microwarpdrive and then use a regular Republic Fleet Medium Shield Extender, or just the FS9 if you don't want to spend money. I got a Fleeting Web and a Faint Scoped Warp Scrambler. And in the lows, I got a Tech 1 Micro Auxiliary Power Core. And then just double Tech 2 Magnetic Field Stabilizers for as much DPS as possible. And speaking of DPS, we got even more DPS because Small Hybrid Burst Aerator is increasing our DPS even more. And then just a Tech 2 EM Screen Reinforcer just to plug the resist hole a bit, because we have really good thermal and kinetic resistances. And that brings us up to, we've almost got 3,000 shields, and despite this being a fit with, you know, only two defensive mods on the entire fit, you know, just the rig and the medium shield extender, still has almost 11,000 effective hit points, and, you know, pretty decent resist, and it doesn't really have a hole too, and having high thermal and kinetic resist is pretty nice against a lot of ships in the metagame right now, at least in terms of the frigate small gang metagame. So yeah, the point of this fit mostly is just to do as much DPS as possible, like the Merlin. With Void, we're rocking 365 DPS cold, which is really good. With Heat, we can bring it up to almost 420 DPS. I am running two implants for this. They're not fitting implants though, so they are optional. And that's the 3% small hybrid damage implant. This costs 2 million ISK and Jitter. And then a 1% to all damage implant, which again is going to cost you around 700 to 800k, usually less than 1 million ISK in Jitter. So I am spending 3 million ISK for these two implants, but they're entirely optional. With them combined, you get it just a bit more than 4% extra DPS, which is nice to have. The Harpy bonuses specifically, the frigate bonus is 4% to shield resistances, which is the same as the Merlin. Then you get 10% optimal range. And then on the assault frigates bonus, you get a small hybrid damage and then optimal range again. It might seem a bit strange to use the Harpy as a blaster ship with double optimal range bonuses, but since the Harpy just has great stats, it's still really powerful, I think. The bonus is not wasted at all. And if you do swap over to a Null here, the double optimal range bonus actually gives you 7 kilometer optimal on Null, which is great. It means that the Harpy is actually deals with scram kites very well. And you know, with here you can put 300 DPS out of that range. It also means you can change your tactics too. Like if you want to go up against a close range brawler, let's say maybe a Saber. I think you can probably kill a Saber at zero anyway with your all-in stats. But if you were to try and min-max an engagement where a ship does a lot of damage really close, like maybe a Catalyst or something like that, you could abuse your range bonus by kiting at 7 kilometers against other blaster ships. Although, again, you do have great resistance against blaster ships, so maybe it's a moot point. But there are some nuances to this fit that you can use to get around. It mostly just makes it so you are very strong against ground kiters. It's very hard for them to take advantage of the fact that you have blasters. Speaking of the Harpy itself, one of the reasons that makes it so good is it has a sub 4 second align. Almost every other assault frigate takes longer than 4 seconds to warp off, and because of how the server ticks work, you always warp at the end of the second. It's kind of very similar to the fly time mechanics in a way. What this means is that the Harpy warps off in 4 seconds, but the AFs that have like 4.3 second aligns, like the NU, they take 5 seconds to warp. And having this like normal kind of Tech 1 frigate window for time to warp means that you don't get caught by tactical destroyers, like general shit frigates that aren't tacklers. And it's really nice for roaming. Ships like the Ennu, unfortunately, will get locked up by destroyers and by just generic frigates, like, you know, generic Merlin or something, which makes it a bit harder to roam. You'll end up having to crash the gate or burn a lot more. The Harpy is quite slow. It only goes 330 ms base speed, and with MWD on, it only goes 2k a second, just over 2.2k a second. So the main weakness of this Harpy is how slow it is, but it has great stats otherwise. Like, this can outbrawl a lot of T3Ds. So yeah, I'd recommend you give the Harpy a go. It's really fun to fly. It does a fuck ton of DPS. It's still tanky, just with the two mods. You can make it even tankier if you want. You can drop a mag stab for a damage control. You can maybe drop the DPS rig if you want for, you know, another field extender or another EM rig to plug the resist even more. But yeah, it's a great ship. I definitely recommend flying it. It's really easy to fly. It doesn't have much weaknesses aside from the fact that it's slow and it will die to gate cams quite frequently. Yeah, I mean, I personally don't get any people who hate anyone in real life. It's not my... Alright, let's go. They're like yellow boxing me. Okay, he's aggressed. Let's go, bro. Rip to your toonie. Let's see how many we can take down before we get blapped. I mean, I am gonna die here, but... I mean, if we can pop like 3 or 4 claws, then... Let's get the claws down because they do more DPS. Oh shit. Let's go on this one that's closer. The claws do a lot of DPS. So I'm gonna pop pretty soon. Also, the Eris is shooting to my resist, so I do kind of have that. Fuck, I can't MWD because there's a Raptor on me. Oh. That was fun. Killed three claws at least. I don't think I reacted fast enough to the Raptor getting a scram on me. It's pretty bad there. Oh, it's a Professor here. 340 MS, he has one speed mod. Probably using the beam nanofit then. I would imagine he's trying to warp. There's a rapid cancer caracal here though, unfortunately.
Warp drive active.
I would like to fight the Confessor. We'll see what happens. I can't fight him with the Caracal though. There's an Algus here. Let's see if anything will show up. Just the Caracal is following.
Warp drive active.
Maybe they went to the wrong gate. Oh, no, they came here. Thank you. But it's like Tech 1 missiles. Okay, we'll just see what happens. The Confessor's here. Maybe he will attack me on the other side. See what he does. We got 45 seconds to kill him before Caracal comes in. Yeah, he's gonna be that beam fit. Might take some damage here while we stabilize the orbit, but I think we've got this guy. Caracal has about 20 seconds. We're definitely going to kill this guy before the Caracal comes in. Oh, he had implants. Nice. And that's the Caracal, but we are gone. Baiting with one launcher. No, I think he was using all of his launchers. It doesn't make sense for him to use only one.
Drive active.
Another gay test. If you touch the word gay, then you are gay. Not with what? With your mouse cursor? I mean, if you type that, then technically you're gay, right? Because it's, if you're on your phone, because then you like typed it up and then you pressed the middle thing. Oh, there's a lot of shit coming. Double Confessor, Corax, Comoran. Malediction. Okay, basically a huge blob. Planet 7 is the good one in here, right?
Warp drive.
Hopefully
active.
The Malediction won't tackle me. Nice. The CO2 guy might snipe them a bit. Only gay if you push back. So it's not, if you just sit there and take it, it's not gay. This Confessor coming here. I really hate the fucking pokers at zero. Coercer coming too. I don't really want to get sniped by a Confessor the entire time I'm fighting a Coercer. I mean, he doesn't have friends yet though. This guy's died to me before though, so I mean, he's definitely gonna ask for help. He's not gonna be someone who just fights. Okay, he will get help and I will probably die to the blob, but I will kill a Confessor, so it's probably worth it. It's definitely worth doing that. They're losing more risk.